hard on this. Thank you for choosing to spend your Sunday evening with us. It means a lot.
Yes, everybody. Once again, I'd like to apologize for the delay of show. We wanted to make sure we had it picture perfect for everybody here.
Yeah.
All right, everybody. So let me tell you something. So as far as I know, we're a national symphony and fraternity, correct?
Yes.
So I think in order to understand that we are a national fraternity, we need to go back to our history.
I think we do too.
I think we need to go back all the way back to 1898 with our founder, Austin Everett Mills.
I am Austin Everett Mills, and on October 6th, 1898, at the New England Conservatory in Boston, Massachusetts, I founded Phi Mu Alpha for people who love music. But I don't know what to call it.
You're right, Austin. Well, I have something to show you. Come with me.
And 2 years later, on October 6th, 1900, with the admission of a group of men at Philadelphia.
Above all others, waves the red and black.
must forever be loyal to thy memory.
The object of this
for the best and truest part of the spirit, the mutual welfare and brotherhood,
the advancement of music in America,
and the loyalty to the alma mater.
Thank you. Banner everywhere, for the land of the
we love and always will adore. Our voices raise in singing our tribute to our girls, to the sweetheart.
Thank you.
way to the moon. Everyone welcome Jacob Torrey!
Thank you.
everybody.
Yeah. Before we get to our normally scheduled programming, we've had a guest contestant.
I think we did.
Did we?
Yes.
Everyone, welcome to the stage. He, Nathan Baskin.
Possibly the oldest public classical institution. The name is still here today, and the origin of our dear nickname, the Classic City. Music is incredibly prevalent in the classics, in fact, including works you've heard multiple times. The Iliad and the Odyssey are most known of these epics, authored by Homer. For an incredible amount of time, classicists considered Homer to be a real person, until the 20th century, when classicists ventured to Turkey, and they found a school of bards that would tell stories and play songs. This compositional performance was then linked to Greek rhapsodes, meaning song stitchers, where they would perform the song as they went. Homer was then believed to be a fictional personality who actually attached to their tales like a patron, his visage of a blind poet being noticed as a fictitious character in many of his attributed works. This is noticed in anchor points, which are identically repeated lines, such as one of note, which appears 20 times in the Odyssey and 6 times in the Iliad. Reading, but when young Dawn showed herself again with rosy-tipped fingers. From these repetitive lines, a rhapsode would then compose the next act of the performance. My goal today is to replicate what these may have been like, so to you we present a classical rhapsody. First of two pieces shall be the epic Gilgamesh, which was written and composed by Peter Pringle and arranged and transliterated by me with string arrangements by Austin Cook.
Thank you.
fun beast that,
Just me saying a story.
You might have heard it before. It was written by Gaius Curtis Cabanis in about 91 AD. It's called Smells Like Teen Spirit.
Thank you.
beastie eye.
It's impressive.
It is very impressive.
Now, I made this announcement a lot, but as y'all know, as one PM class, we raised $350 for singing Valentine's, right?
Yes, we did.
And I know a lot of you in this room have heard this announcement, but if you have a low commitment situationship, a high commitment relationship, or a friendship, and you want to send them a singing Valentine, you can call our singing singles to say, can't have a lot of love, minus Austin.
Thank you.
script and invite my big Tyler Brown Whitaker.
Yes!
I may or may not be singing Baby by Justin Bieber. Oh, whoa, whoa. Oh, whoa, whoa. Oh, whoa, whoa. You know you love me. I know you care. Dear sovereign lover, and I'll be there. You are my lover. You are my heart. And we will never, ever, ever be apart. Are we an item? Are we playing? Just friends, what are you saying? Since there's another love that you do now. What do you think of the night? Oh, yeah. Baby.
Thank you.
be Lutala, huh? I lost my other hosting bed. It appears that he just got tired of this and decided to start going home. Introducing Liam Taylor with everybody else that he's playing with an arrangement of Going Home.
Thank you. train is easy to show. Tons of factors for me.
What's as intriguing, half so familiar. TV.
As one's out of reach. Am I not sensitive, clever, well-mannered, considerate, passionate, charming, as kind as I'm handsome? In heir to a throne,
you are everything maidens could wish for.
Then why no?
I know that girl must be mad.
Yeah.
something good, and we need to hold our heads high. And we just, we need to remember who we are and why we're here. So, let every good fellow now join in the song.
Fiddle a company!
Just to each other and pass it along.
Fiddle a company!
Should time or occasion compel us to part?
Viva la company!
These days shall forever enliven the heart.
Viva la company! Viva la, viva la, viva la more! Viva la, viva la, viva la more! Viva la more, viva la more! Viva la company!
If you ever need a fellow to move your chair,
viva la company!
Call my man Benjamin Gruber.
See the Symphonia's band.